Hello, my name is André da Silva. I'm an assistant professor for vegetable cropping systems at the Department of Horticulture at Auburn University. And today I will give you guys in this class, I will be talking about the strawberry irrigation overview. During the class, I will be quickly talk about what are the most common irrigation systems that we have for strawberry production, but also how should we be calculating the strawberry water demand? How much water should we apply? And that's an important information for you guys to achieve our maximum yield on your production. So let's move on and start talking about the irrigation systems. So first of all, what are the most common strawberry irrigation systems? So currently, drip irrigation and overhead are the most common used for strawberry production. They have their benefits, their pros and cons, and that's what I want to quickly talk today. So drip irrigation, what is drip irrigation? Drip irrigation is when you install a drip line in the planted line of your strawberries, or you put one drip line between two rows. So that you're gonna apply water to trinkle, and then you're gonna provide water to the root zone. The benefits of drip irrigation is that you apply water directly to the root zone. You are spoon feed your strawberry. They are receiving water in their root zone. When water is being uptake, it push nutrients with it, and then you achieve the best yields. However, the drip irrigations do not prevent for frost protection like the overhead. But the drip line, it's our currently most efficient system. Usually we say that 95% of the water applied reach the strawberry root zone. On the other hand, the overhead is not as bad. It has about 85 to 90% of efficiency. However, the overhead water applications allow water to be lost by wind through drift, or water to being evaporated in the sun. So when you are doing overhead irrigation, try to apply your water early in the morning or later in the afternoon when wind is not blowing too much and sun is not as high in the top of the plants. So you're gonna have a better efficiency of your systems. Overhead is particularly good because in the case of frost, you can apply water to use the overhead and apply water as a frost protection. So this is one important thing for the overhead. While under drip irrigation for frost protection, growers have been using row covers. So those are practices that you need to consider when selecting what irrigation system you're gonna be using. A quick remember, drip irrigation is usually used with plastic mulching, which is a technique that increases the soil temperature and consequently the development of the crop. While the overhead, you need to do that in bare soil. So you need to be prepared for the different irrigation systems and how to select the best one that will fit your needs. And your system. So now that you guys know that drip and overhead, I mean overhead, but it's a sprinkler irrigation, we can start talking about how much water should we be applying. So that's the topic for our next slide. But before I talk about strawberry, I want you guys to learn a little bit about crop water demand. Crop water demand is basically how much water is required by your agricultural field or system, regardless of the crop we have. So that's the reason why I'm showing this field corn, sweet corn field. So the crop water demand is also known as the crop evapotranspiration, which is simple calculated by this equation on the top here. So the crop evapotranspiration, also known as ETC, is equal your reference evapotranspiration, ETO, multiplied by a crop coefficient that varies according to the crop development. And in this small video here, you're gonna understand what's going on. So that's why I'm showing corns and not strawberry, because it's going to be more illustrative for you guys. So just imagine you have a regular field. Rainfall usually occurs in your field. So when you have rainfall, water is being applied, simulating irrigation, or actually simulate rainfall. Water is penetrating the soil. It's being uptake by the plants. Plants do photosynthesis, but also water is lost by evaporation and transpiration. So when you combine the loss of water by evaporation and transpiration, you have your water demand. In this case, our crop evapotranspiration. So the ETO of our crop, our ETC equation, the ETO here represent our soil evaporation, while our crop coefficient represent our transpiration. And luckily for us, this number were already prepared, and that's what we're gonna talk in our next topic. So imagine that we have our evapotranspiration. That's the equation that we need to do to calculate our daily water lost by the soil. But I don't want you guys to learn how to calculate it, because it depends on several factors like temperature, solar radiation, relative humidity, wind speed, even the location on the earth where you're gonna have your field. So there are many topics involved. And luckily for us, we have weather station ready to do that. And in most of the states, we have already universities who are set up network system. For example, in Alabama, we have the Auburn University Mesonet, which provide you exactly the ETO value for every single day. Same for Georgia, where we have the Georgia Weather Network, or at Florida, where University of Florida developed the FAUN, which is the Florida Automated Weather Network. So identify your local weather station or your local weather network, and you're gonna have access for your ETO. It is not hard, it's gonna give you a straightforward number, and that basic number for that day or for that week is what we need. This is just an overview for you to see what is the reference evapotranspiration. So you're gonna have by the end a number, and that number is what we're gonna use. And that number represent the volume of water lost by the soil during that day. So moving on, in addition to that ETO or reference evapotranspiration, you're gonna need to know now the strawberry crop coefficients. Like all the crops, the strawberry have three crop coefficients that were already established before. This coefficient is divided in KC initial, which represent our transplanting stages, it is 0.4. Our KC in the mid season from the vegetative, flowering, and fruiting stage, which is 0.85. And from the end of the season, when you're about to harvest and fruits are already achieving maturity, which is the KC end, 0.75. So when you know those numbers and you see your crop in those stages, you can start to apply the equation that we just talking about. So let's start with an example for you. If you install a drip irrigation and you're gonna do a daily irrigation scheduling. We are located in North Alabama. We have strawberries at flowering. So therefore, KC in the mid season, 0.85. And I just got our data for the Mesonet here at Auburn University, and we got a daily evapotranspiration of 0.09 inches. What do we do now? So in a simple step, we're gonna apply our equation. Crop evapotranspiration is equal our reference evapotranspiration times our crop coefficients. Therefore, 0.09 inch of reference evapotranspiration times 0.85. This will give us 0.08 inch, and that's the volume of water you need to apply to supply your strawberry plants with the water lost in that day. So you make sure there is no water stress. Simple like that. If you know this equation, you know where to find your ETO, you know where to find your crop coefficients that I just provide to you, your crop coefficient does not change. This is a requirement for strawberry plants. So it's going to be the same KC early season, KC mid season, and KC end season. You can calculate the volume of water strawberries are uptaking every day in your field. Another example, just for you guys to moving on, how are you gonna calculate your evapotranspiration if you have a sprinkler irrigation now, but you are applying water every 2 days? So once again, we are in North Alabama, we have flowering period, but now we calculate that the volume of water during the entire week was 1.3 inches and during the entire week was this, and you're gonna irrigate every 2 days. So how are you gonna do that? You're gonna get the same equation. You're gonna do 1.3 inches, which was the water consumed by the reference evapotranspiration in the past week, multiply by your crop coefficient, 0.85, and you're gonna have 1.1 inches of water for the 7 days of the week. So that's how much water your crop required during that week. Once you do that, you're gonna see that 1.1 divided by the 7 days required you to apply 0.16 inches per day. Or if you're gonna do every other day, like 2 days event, two day interval, 0.32 inches. So simple like that, you're gonna be doing a very quick and simple, but still accurate irrigation scheduling, which is the crop water demand, the use of the crop evapotranspiration to identify the volume of water required by strawberries. Simple like that. So in short, just to give you a take home message, strawberries, they are commonly used drip or sprinkler irrigation. The drip irrigation, yes, it is more efficient, but keep in mind that sprinkler can also be used for frost protection. So see the benefit for your system, for your agricultural field. Would it be better for you to have a sprinkler or drip? What are you looking for? That's the main point you need to do. See what's gonna be the best for your field. And finally, if you use the crop water demand calculation to determine irrigation volumes, it's gonna help you to properly manage water in your field. You're gonna have not only saving with water, but you're gonna increase in yield. You're gonna minimize nutrient leaching, which is commonly seen when you have overhead irrigation. Consequently, you're gonna reduce cost of production, but increase your profits. And that's what I want you guys to keep in mind. Properly irrigation scheduling can maximize your yields and your profits. With this, I would like to be short. My name is Andre again. I would like to thank you guys for watching this class. If you need any help, feel free to contact me. Below here, you have my email, and I'm completely open for questions and come and help you anytime. Thank you very much.